Hello again, I am Blunty, and inside this box is an action camera thingy bit that has been quite hotly anticipated ever since it was announced a few months back, I think. At the moment, it is only really being sold on the Chinese market, although you can get it from several websites, like the one that sent this in to me to review, which is gearbest.com. So, I wouldn't normally do an unboxing of a little action camera style thing. This is GoPro-style action camera, but this one is packaged particularly nicely. I mean, yes, the card is just an ordinary cardboard box, but we'll get to that in a moment. We might as well have a look at the spec sheet on the back before we go too much further. Now, the reason people have got excited about this is because, number one, it is very inexpensive, especially when compared to GoPros, and number two, the specs sheet is quite impressive. So, f2.8 lens, field of view 156 degrees. Here's something to get excited about. 1080p, 60 frames per second. Hooray for that. It also has a Sony image sensor in there. Can you read that? Let's get it close. Can we read that? That's encouraging. Sony make the best CMOS sensors out there at the moment. So every time I see a camera that has a Sony sensor inside, I have reason to get slightly more excited about it. The rest is just sort of standard stuff about power and battery and charging and all that sort of stuff. So let me show you what I'm talking about. See, look at that. I mean, it's almost like a brown cardboard version of an Apple unboxing, really. And this is a little bit dirty because I have been shooting with it on my way home this morning. But yeah, the camera itself is really, really nice. It feels superb. The plastic feels nice. It's very, very light. You know, the buttons feel solid and everything, and the lens looks nice and clean. It is a glass lens, so we're encouraged there. And it has a tripod mount built into the camera itself, which is also very handy. Very, very, very few action cameras I've come across have that, and I like that because it just means you can whack it on a little gorilla pod or on a grip or a selfie stick or whatever you need to put it on there without having to worry about extra bits and pieces and cases and mounts and all that sort of stuff. Now, a little Wi-Fi button around the side. I haven't been able to test the Wi-Fi yet because this is only for the Chinese market and the app, though I can download it on the Australian App Store. It's all in Chinese and I can't read a damn thing. But I've got it connected, I just can't figure out how to use the app, so I'm going to have some Googling and translating attempt at that. So under this little door here is your micro SD slot and your HDMI mini output. I haven't tested that yet. I'm going to do a full review of this, and I'm going to do comparisons to things like, you know, the GoPro. We're going to do a head-to-head shootout to see how it stacks up against my GoPro Hero 3 Plus Black Edition here. I'm also going to put it up against the Mobius here, which is one of the most popular choices for inexpensive action cams at the moment. Whether or not you've heard of this depends really if you're in the hobbyist market for drones. It's a very, very, very popular with quadcopter flyers because of its profile. Very flat, very thin, very light. It makes it easy to mount onto quadcopters and bits and pieces like that. And you might have seen me using this when I'm reviewing various quadcopters strapped to the brim of my hat to get point of view footage when I'm flying those things around. You know, when I point the drone with the camera at myself, you might have noticed this sitting on my hat. I don't know whether I'll do a full review of that because it's been around for a while, although this is the new version free, but anyway, we're getting off the point. So I'm going to do a comparison to the GoPro, which is the standard in the industry, and this, which is pretty much the standard for inexpensive ones, and, you know, I'm looking forward to seeing how it stacks up because it seems very, very promising. And I did shoot some footage with it, which I'll show you in just a moment, and so let's just get this battery door off. This battery was a little bit fiddly to pop off. There we go. So that's not coming off accidentally. That's encouraging. Although I do worry that I might lose this little thing here that goes over the accessory ports. I might kind of tape that down or something. I'm a little worried that could go missing. Now, it is not waterproof out of the box. It is. You can get waterproof cases for it, although as you can see, it is slightly different arrangement of the lens positioning, so it's not going to fit in GoPro accessories. It is ever so slightly different shape, but like I said, we do have the metal tripod mat in the body itself to help us out. But yeah, if you need it weatherproof, there's weatherproof accessories for it, or if you need to go diving or whatnot, there you can sort that out. But this is an above water camera out of the box experience. If we pull out the little insert here, we continue the lovely unboxing experience. Whoops, wrong side. That's the side I want. So inside the little sort of pouches there, we get the battery, which is just a little 3.7 volt. What's the capacity, actually? 1,010 milliamp hour batteries. So I'm not sure how long that's going to last in that camera, but that is, I believe, higher capacity than the default battery you get with the GoPro. I think those are about 850 or something. I forget. Well, now it doesn't really matter. We'll talk about that in the full review and comparisons and stuff, I guess. And a short little mini USB cable, flat cable, so it doesn't get tangled or anything. I do like the flat ones. Makes them easier to throw on the bag, and you're not going to get tangled up and tied in knots and everything. But that's it. So, like I said, on my way home, I threw in the battery, and I had, I guess, I don't know, probably 30% charge, judging by how long it lasted. But I did get a few shots on the way home. I pointed this at a few things just to see how it got. I was quite impressed. Take a look at this. So, as you can see, very, very clear and crisp and clean. The colours look good, the white balance looks good, and most importantly of all, it seems to be dealing really, really well with dynamic range. You can see the highlights, the bit where the sun is, you know, the pools of sunlight and the bright spots in the sky and all that, are not washing out, they're not bleeding out into pure white blobs of awful, ugly hideousness, and you can still see really well into the shadows most of the time. So that dynamic range is really impressive, and that is indicative. That's a sign that they're not lying about having a Sony sensor in there, because that is very typical of Sony's sensors lately. They do very, very well with that dynamic range. It's adjusting very well for changes in exposure, going from light to dark and back again. Indoors, it's dealing very well too. Most of these cheapy action cams are terrible in low light, really, really awful. You know, they're grained up, they got fuzzy and grainy and noisy and purple specks and all that kind of stuff. But this, very, very clean, and it's not getting blurry. It's not dropping the shutter speed too low, so you're not getting tons of motion blur and ugly stuff like that. It looks really clean. So yeah, I got home and I started looking at this footage and I was really impressed. This is way more impressive than I thought it would be. The next videos, I might make one or two, maybe even three videos comparing it to different cameras. You know, maybe I'll do one video for those ones, one video for those ones, or maybe I'll come out and I don't know what I'm going to do yet. All I know is that I absolutely have to get some head-to-head stuff between these two, because I think for this, which is like a quarter of the price of what this cost me, something like that. I haven't done the math, I'm just trying to go off the top of my head here. But it seems like it would be an unbelievably good value action camera, one of the best I've ever come across in that sort of price range, and one of the better ones in any price range as far as I'm concerned. It, you know, people got really, really excited about it, and I think perhaps for very good reason. So that's it for that. Thanks for watching. I am Blunty. I will catch you next time, and I'll, throughout the next week and a half or more, depending on when I get time and how the weather treats me, I'm going to take these out and shoot them, and I'm going to go shoot this at night as well, because we haven't got any true night shots from it yet, and we're going to just compare. Well, you know, subscribe to my channel, you'll get fed all the videos, or follow me on Twitter, because I Twitter about all my videos as they go out, you know, whichever works best for you. Do both if you like. I don't really care. I don't live and die by the big numbers on my Twitter followers or anything like that. My sense of self-worth is not connected to the numbers on my subscriber or Twitter feeds. See you guys.